The Unifying Meditation begins here. It contains detailed instructions to help you establish complete oneness within. It is specifically designed to free you from polarities, that is, imbalances or conflicts in your life. Listen to the introduction if you do not know about polarities. Throughout the meditation, I'll give you instructions on the steps to take. Whenever I do, simply follow the instructions that you understand, the ones that look clear, sound relevant, or feel right at the time. There are a lot of them, and you are best only to follow the ones you notice. What you notice is useful. Relax about any that you miss. The meditation involves three basic steps, and each step has a number of parts to it. So give yourself time to become familiar with it all. Repeated playing helps. As you listen, simply follow the instructions being given at each point. Just let the results and any previous instructions take care of themselves. You concentrate on the instruction you are being given and forget the rest. Also, if at any stage I suggest that you do something you don't want to do at that point, you do what you want to do. It will be right for you then. The first step is to consider the changes you want and to select a polarity. To begin the first step, you simply take a few moments to consider your purpose for doing the meditation this time. What is it that you want to change? What do you wish to integrate, balance, or resolve? Are the situations, events, or experiences inside you or outside you, or both inside and outside you? Whatever you're considering, there will be different parts to it. Notice each of the different parts. What feelings, thoughts, impulses, people, groups of people, things, situations or events are involved? How are they related or connected to each other? What's happening between them? What's happening between them may be obvious or subtle, or perhaps nothing is happening at all. Consider what you want to change. Now, select two of the parts you've noticed and leave the others until later. Make your selection now. At this stage, it is helpful to remember that the intended result of doing the meditation is unification. The meditation promotes integration, oneness, cooperation, alignment, harmony, continuity, and openness. So, with particular awareness of the two polarized parts you've chosen, imagine what the best outcome would be. If everything was perfect, what would be happening? How would each of the two parts be in themselves? And how would they be relating or connected? You are imagining their perfect integration, unity and alignment, their perfect oneness, and a perfect cooperation, freedom, openness, harmony and transparency between them. You are considering what would be the best outcome. Whatever you're imagining is fine, even if all you can currently imagine is vague, non-specific, or unclear. Understanding and awareness usually evolve and change as the meditation proceeds, and usually become more specific, when there is a need. As fully as possible, then, imagine or fantasize the best. See it clearly, hear it distinctly, feel it acutely. Describe it to yourself. While you do this, you may also be aware of things you consider to be less than ideal. If you are, use that awareness to fantasize what would be ideal. And as you fantasize, imagine that what seems best is actually happening. It's happening now. Your ideal exists now. You now shift your attention to being grounded. Become aware of the physical sensations in your body. You might look at these sensations, listen to these sensations, or feel these sensations. You might describe them to yourself. However you do it, simply be aware of the physical sensations anywhere in your body. Be aware of what's happening in your whole body. Check your whole body for sensation. And as you check, include the parts of your body where nothing or almost nothing seems to be happening. Now also, become aware of the physical things and events around you. What is happening right now? Look at what's there and what's happening. Listen to what's there and what's happening. Touch what's there and feel what is touching you. And taste and smell what's on the outside too. Now practice being aware of both together. Be aware of the inside and the outside at the same time. Be aware of the physical sensations anywhere in your body, at the same time as you notice the physical things and events around you. Physical movement or fantasies of movement help produce more results from the meditation. So at this point, if you're sitting or lying down, get up and move around. If you're unable to walk around in the area in which you're doing the meditation, move the parts of your body that you can move, and move them as much as is reasonable for you to move them. If you're unable to move much at all, move those parts of your body that you can move, and imagine or fantasize that you're moving the other parts of your body. The second step of the meditation begins now. You unify yourself with the polarity and so free yourself from it. As you are moving physically, again, consider the situations or events with which you started. What is it that you want to be different? And how could the situations or events be perfect? See, hear, and feel this perfection as fully and completely as you can. Talk about the perfection to yourself. Remember to imagine the final outcome that would be perfect. You are making the fantasy, and in fantasy anything is possible. So only settle for the best resolution you can imagine. Make the pictures, sounds, feelings, tastes and smells you believe, think or feel would be best. You now select one of the two parts of the polarity you chose, and you imagine that you are totally one with it. Whatever it is, you are it. Look at it and see yourself to be completely the way it looks to you. Listen to it and hear yourself to be completely the way it sounds to you. Feel or touch it and notice that you feel completely the way it feels to you. Notice any taste or smell, and in your oneness with it, you taste and smell completely the way it tastes and smells to you. Also, notice what this part is doing, and in your fantasy, you are acting completely the way it acts. Talk your way into being that part. You are that part, fully and completely. No matter how acceptable it usually is to you, you are it. Being at one with this part may be immediately freeing, or it may not. Whatever you experience, whether pleasant or not, persist with becoming one with this part. Your inner unity comes as you accept whatever you are experiencing as you do this. So face your experience and relax into it. Open up to your experience of being this part. Allow the light and sound of it. Be whatever this part is. Now forget this and ensure that you are well grounded. Again, be aware of the physical events and things on the inside and outside of you. Give your primary attention to these, whatever else you may be thinking, feeling, or experiencing. Keep moving your body or moving around from place to place. In whatever you're doing, be casual, relaxed, aware, optimistic, easy, and alert. Look at your physical sensations. Listen to them. Feel them or taste or smell them. Talk about them to yourself. At the same time, be aware of the physical things and events around you. Look at them and see them. Listen to the sounds and hear them. Notice what you're touching and what is touching you. And taste and smell whatever is there. Physical sensations on the inside, physical things and events on the outside. And deliberately notice what is easier, lighter, freer, happier, quieter, and more harmonious. Notice the things of beauty, fragrance, delight, joy, and vitality. You now select the second of the two parts you chose, and you do the same as you did with the first one. Imagine that you are totally one with that part, no matter how acceptable it usually is to you. You look completely the way it looks to you. You sound completely the way it sounds to you. you feel completely the way it feels to you. You taste and smell completely the way it tastes and smells to you. And you act completely the way it acts. You talk yourself into being that part. You are that part, whatever it is. You may experience immediate release, harmony, or light, or you may not. Whatever you experience, as with the first part, persist with becoming one with this part. Complete inner unity and release comes from your acceptance of your experiences. You are this part completely and fully. Now forget this for a while and be aware again of what's happening physically inside and outside you. Notice the physical sensations anywhere in your body. See, hear, feel, taste or smell them, or talk about them to yourself. And notice the physical things and events around you. Again, see, hear, touch, taste, and smell them. Move your body while you do this. In particular, move the parts of your body in which you notice sensation is persisting, parts which are still to become released, open, and free. And move the parts of your body next to these to encourage full release. As you keep moving your body and being aware of what's happening physically inside and outside you, keep being casual, easy, and optimistic. Notice inside your body all the sensations of pleasure, life, ease, harmony, and light. Notice what sounds are enjoyable, and what looks free and open inside your body. Also, notice on the outside the things of beauty, fragrance, delight, joy, and vitality. Use all your senses. Look at, listen to, touch, and taste and smell what is there. The next thing to do is to consider the two parts you have chosen and notice particularly what is happening between them. What's happening may be obvious, subtle, or it may be nothing at all. Whatever activity or inactivity is taking place between the two parts, be that activity. You do this by imagining that you are the two parts of the polarity and what is happening between them. You imagine that you are the whole polarity. While you do, you concentrate on what is happening between the two parts. You are whatever is happening between them. Become one with whatever that is. Again, no matter how acceptable such activity usually is to you, you are that activity. Look at it and see yourself to be completely the way it looks to you. Listen to it and hear yourself to be completely the way it sounds to you. Feel or touch it and feel yourself to be completely the way it feels to you. You taste and smell the way it tastes and smells to you. Talk yourself into being the exchanges taking place between the two parts. Whatever activity or inactivity is taking place between the two parts, you are whatever is taking place. Allow yourself to experience whatever is in your awareness. Persist until you experience the release that signals that you are free. Relax into and accept whatever you are experiencing. Now forget this for a while and be aware again of what's happening physically inside and outside you. Notice the physical sensations anywhere in your body. And notice the physical things and events around you. Again, see, hear, touch, taste and smell them. The inside and the outside. Move your body while you do this. Also, if there are particular parts of your body in which you notice sensation persisting, again, move those parts of your body and the parts of your body next to them to encourage their release. Keep being casual, easy, and optimistic. The third step is to promote unification by being one with a perfect outcome. To begin, you again consider the polarity you chose and be aware of its two parts and what is happening between them. What are they like now? Change is a normal result of the meditation, so if they seem different, accept any differences. And if you also seem different, accept that too. Now again consider how the two parts would be if everything were perfect. What would be best? How would the two parts be in themselves? What would be happening between them? What ideal states would exist? Imagine what the unity, balance, and integration would be if everything was ideal. What would be the cooperation, alignment, continuity, and oneness? The harmony, openness, or freedom? What would be the best outcome? You picture, hear, and feel this outcome as if it is already true. Fully imagine the best outcome. Describe it to yourself. See it clearly, hear it distinctly, feel it acutely. Imagine that whatever is best is actually happening inside and between the two parts you have selected. And concentrate on what would be best, not on what is less than the best. You are imagining the perfect outcome, perfection both within each part and between them. Now you imagine that you are totally at one with this outcome. you are the outcome you are imagining. You are no longer just imagining it, you are it. You look completely the way it looks to you in all its parts and aspects. You sound completely the way it sounds to you. You feel completely the way it feels to you. You act completely the way it acts. And you taste and smell completely the way it tastes and smells to you. You are this perfect outcome. You are that outcome, whatever it is. Be it and persist through whatever you experience while doing this. Relax into and accept your experiences. Freedom, integration, and resolution can be yours. Oneness and unity come from this. Be your perfect outcome. In every way, be your outcome. Now again attend to being fully grounded. Be aware of what's happening physically inside and outside you. Notice the physical sensations anywhere in your body. And notice the physical things and events around you. See, hear, touch, taste and smell them. Describe them to yourself. Move your body while doing this. To release your body, move those parts of your body in which sensation is persisting and the parts of your body next to them to encourage release. Keep moving your body or moving around from place to place. Give your primary attention to the physical parts of your experience, whatever else you may be experiencing. Physical sensations on the inside, physical events and things on the outside. Be casual, relaxed, aware, easy and alert. As you come to the end of the meditation, again consider the unification that would be best. While doing so, be aware of the two parts you chose. You may notice again that there are changes in these, or changes in your response to them. You have been changing as you have followed the instructions. And while you may not know it right now, you are likely to find that the change process continues for some time. Perhaps you are now experiencing a complete sense of union. Perhaps not. If you are yet to experience it, play the meditation again or make a plan now about when you will. Some purposes require repeated use of the meditation during which further progress is usually made. Whatever your present experience, do something as soon as possible which would be natural and normal to do were your imagined unification actually true. It doesn't matter how small or apparently insignificant what you do seems. The important thing is to do something. So give some thought to this now. Of course, in whatever you do, it's realistic to take account of the likely consequences. And from now on, notice the changes that do occur, no matter how small they seem. Notice the way you, other people, situations and events change to unify with your inner freedom and resolution, or with something even better.